Hello, in this video lecture, we're going to learn on the mistakes we do. Go ahead.
In the previous video, a continuation of articles, I provided you a set of guidelines to help you understand some basic rules about the indefinite article A and M. Definite article, the, and zero article. However, there are a lot of special cases that are confusing, especially concerning when to use the and when to use zero article. As a result, many English language learners will use the when it is not necessary or forget to add the when it is necessary. I separate the tricky cases into four groups. For part one, I will focus on unique things and country related things. Keep in mind that there are more special cases that this lesson will focus on only these four areas. Let's start with group one. There are some nouns that are considered unique meaning that the speaker says that noun, the listener already knows what the speaker is referring to because it is common knowledge. Look at the following sentences. The sun is shining brightly. I can't see the moon tonight. Scientists have been searching for another life forms in the universe. In the forest, the air is much cleaner. Look at the sky. It's so blue. Please don't sit on the ground. It's dirty. It's hot. Let's stand in the shade. Let's make the world a better place. If I said this sentence to you, you would understand what I was referring to, right? For most people in the world, they know that there is one sun, one moon, one universe, one sky, and so on. Yes, it's possible that there are more universes, worlds, suns, or moons out there. But for most of us, when we talk, we are generally referring to things in our own universe. The two unique nouns that I want to explain a little more. The first one is shared. If my friend and I were standing outside under the sun and I said, let's stand in the shade, it's possible that there are many areas of shade near us, here or here. However, in this case, it doesn't matter which shared area we choose, anywhere fine, as long as shared. We don't use the sentence like there is shade. Even there is not specific. The other nouns when talk about is the verb. World is a tricky one in many cases. The article is the. Native English speakers often use the word in sentences. For example, Russia is the biggest country in the world. You might also hear a sentence that starts with the word is. For example, the world is changing rapidly. These sentences show us talking about things in the place we are living. However, it is possible to hear your world too. In a perfect world, we would have to worry about what this is, or we want to create a better world for the next generation. For these sentences, there is a feeling of more than one world. We are talking about the world we live in now. We are talking about a place or environment that we dream about. In that case, it is appropriate to use a. So let us see. We went to a park at night, but we could see clearly because dash moon was full. We know it is the moon was full, right? I hope my children live in dash world that is peaceful and clean. Okay, there is only one world, right? So there's peaceful and peace, so it is a. In a world that is peaceful and clean. Let's go ahead. In the second group, we have country related things. I will review the names of the countries, currency, and languages. For most countries, there is no article before the name of the country. There are, however, some countries that requires the before it. The United States, the United Kingdom, the Philippines, the Netherlands, the United Arab Emirates, and the Czech Republic. Next, when you are referring to a country's currency or money, also use the before the name of the currency. For example, the dollar, the yen, the euro, the pound, the won, the yuan, the real, the real, and the peso. Now let's look at language. When you're referring to the name of a language, you do not need to use an article. In other words, there is a zero article. This boy speaks Portuguese. This girl speaks English. This woman speaks Korean. Notice that there is a zero article. Portuguese, German, and Korean are nouns here. However, the rules change if you add the word language after the name of the language, like the pattern in the box. If you use this pattern, you must add the before. The Portuguese language, the Korean language, and the German language. Notice here, Portuguese, Korean, and German act as adjectives.
Tricky articles, confusing special cases, part 2. In the part 1, we focused on unique things and country related things. In part 2, we will talk about location related things and time related things. In location related nouns, some of them use the while some don't. Let's compare which one start with the and which one have no articles. Number 1. Name of oceans, seas, and rivers come after the. The Pacific Ocean, the Caspian Sea, and the Amazon River. On the other hand, lakes and waterfalls generally do not have the before it. Lake Lugano and Niagara Falls. Number 2. Mountain ranges use the. The Alps are the Canadian Rockies. Notice that I said mountain ranges and not a mountain.
Yes.
If it is just one mountain like Mount Everest or Mount Kilimanjaro, there is no article before. Number 3. Deserts. Deserts use the Sahara Desert, the Gobi Desert. Number 4. Specific regions often use the. The Middle East, the Balkans. Actually, within other countries like United States, there are specific areas where we use the Northwest, the West Coast, and the South. Now here's a little challenge. What's the difference between saying I'm going to the South versus I'm going South? In the first sentence, it has the, which emphasizes a specific area in southern United States. However, in the second sentence, I am just you saying that I am going in the direction of south. It is not a specific area. In the second sentence, there is no article before south. In the last group, we are going to see. So, there will be no article. And as we said, the Caribbean Sea. Before seas, there will be. So let's go ahead. In the last group, we talk about time related events. I want to highlight how to use or not use articles related to holidays, time periods, and dates. To do this, let me share with you about one of my favorite holidays. Let's take an example. I love Chinese New Year. When I was growing up in the 1980s, I often went to Chinatown to see the lion dances. Every year, the start date changes because of the lunar calendar. One year, it was on February 14th. This past year, it was on the 8th of February. I hope it is never on Friday the 13th. that's an unlucky day. First, let's look at holidays. Do not use an article before the name of your holiday. In other words, I shouldn't say I love the Chinese New Year. It's wrong. Next is time periods. When you are talking about a time period, like a decade or a specific time of importance, add the 1960s, the 1980s, the 90s, or the Renaissance period, the Middle Ages, the Information Age. Lastly, let's talk about dates. There are three sentences related to dates. One year, it was on February 14th. This past year, it was on 8th of February. I hope it is never on Friday the 13th. We have months, we have days of the week. Finally, we have ordinary numbers. As you notice, two sentences include the before ordinary number. One sentence doesn't. Unfortunately, there is not really an easy way to learn the pattern. So take the time to study the pattern in the chart. In the first sentence, if you have month plus ordinary number, like February 14th, there is no the article. If you have ordinary number plus month, like 8th of February, use the before ordinary number. The 8th of February, if you have day of the week plus ordinary number, Friday and 13th, use the between the day of the week and ordinary number, Friday the 13th.